Welcome to the coming apocalypse. Evangelist and pastor Paul Begley will take you on a journey into the end times prophecy. He'll examine current world events and explain how they relate to the end times. For decades, Pastor Begley has provided people all over the world with an understanding of today's world events from a biblical perspective. Now, here's your host, Pastor Paul Begley.
Are you serious? Well, we are very serious today. Matter of fact, welcome to the coming apocalypse. I'm Pastor Paul Begley, and we're going to be talking about signs in the heavens. Signs in the heavens. Now, there's a lot of discussion that's going on. Scientists have been talking about since 1985 when NASA said they discovered Planet X. Now, they had a team of scientists work on this project for 7 years. When the lead scientist died in 1992, NASA went dark. Never said another word about it publicly. But of course, they never stopped working on what they had discovered. It wasn't until, and there's been a lot of theories and conspiracy theories and all kinds of things about this elusive planet. Matter of fact, you can go back to the ancients, some of the ancient Sumerian texts, they talk about the destroyer, or a planet that would eventually come back and create havoc on the earth. Well, I've looked in the Bible, of course. We do know there's going to be some deep impact. It's going to take place in the book of Revelation, and especially if you're in the 8th chapter. But before I go there, I really want to talk to you in this broadcast about the fact that is there a Planet X that's going, or a binary system that's going to go by, even though it's a million miles away, it's not going to hit us. But as it goes by, does it affect our planet, our solar system? Does it bring more debris with it, more asteroids? Do those collide with some of them that we're already dealing with, because we're dealing with a lot of them? And is that what's going to bring about some of these biblical apocalyptic events that's prophesied in your Bible? We're going to find out all about this. It's in the Bible. We'll be right back in just a few moments. Secrets of the Sacred Incense, an unbelievable, extraordinary journey to find the apothecary, the mystical caves in the Holy Land where the sacred incense of the first temple were discovered. Come with me on a journey that will literally enlighten you to the truth of the last days, the biblical ramifications of the third temple, all in this powerful DVD. Get a copy of it now at my website. All right, folks, all right. Signs in the heavens. Remember, Jesus said there would be signs, great signs and fearful sights in the heavens. Well, first of all, let's go to Joel chapter 2. A couple verses here of things. There's going to be a lot going on in the last days just before the coming of the Lord. And Joel tells us that in this second chapter of Joel. But he says these words. If you look at verse 30, Joel 2, verse 30, "And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord come." Now, it's amazing when I read this, because you're like, okay, how does the sun turn dark? My whole life I've always wondered about that. Okay, I can get it with the moon turning blood red. We know that a lunar eclipse does that. Matter of fact, we just went through that four blood moon process that all landed on high Jewish feast days. They were apocalyptic signs, especially to watch with Israel. But recently, we've been having blood moons all over the world with no lunar eclipse. They're not supposed to happen. Folks have seen them in Florida, New York, Indiana. They've been seen in California. They've been seen in England. They've been seen in Australia. Unbelievable. Blood red moons. People have been taking pictures. They've been sending them around. And they're not even scheduled. They're unscheduled. Is that a sign in the heavens? Well, it could be. And we're going to continue to talk about that in a moment. But how does the sun go dark? Well, there's some scientific information we've gathered this week that helps us understand this. I need you to go with me to the book of Amos, if you will. Go to Amos chapter 5. Now, you know in the book of Revelation it talks about wormwood, or, you know, wormwood meaning poisonous water or bitter. okay? Matter of fact, in the Ukrainian Bible, the word wormwood in Revelation is Chernobyl. That's the word. And we all know what happened at Chernobyl 30 years ago with a radioactive meltdown, really. Well, here's what it says in Amos chapter 5, verses 7 and 8 and 9. Let's read it. Ye who turn judgment to wormwood and leave off righteousness in the earth, seek him that maketh the seven stars and Orion, and turneth the shadow of death into the morning, and maketh the day dark with night, that calleth for the waters of the sea, and poureth them out upon the face of the earth. The Lord is his name, that strengtheneth the spoiled against the strong, so that the spoiled shall come against the fortress. Who is it that can turn the sun dark? Who is it that can, who made the seven stars and Orion? Now, we know that Orion is the name of a constellation. And so here's why I'm going back to now Planet X. In 1985, as I said, NASA said they found an elusive, huge planet deep in space, what they call Planet X. They stopped talking about 1992. But in December of last year, December of 2015, scientists, astronomers in observatories in the mountains of Chile discovered Planet X. They said, there it is. We've spotted it. They have it. And it was in the constellation of Orion. Also, when they studied it, there are other planets orbiting this thing, seven of them. Now, you're looking at, it says here, seek him that maketh the seven stars and Orion. All right, you say, okay, Pastor, okay, don't mess with my mind here with this. Well, go with me now to Job for a minute, and there's a reason I'm going to show you something in the Scripture, and this is very fascinating, and it makes one have to start to wonder if these are the apocalyptic signs of the end times. Now, if you go to Job, and remember, Job's just been robbed. I mean, they've stole everything he has. His kids were killed in a terrible storm. He's got boils from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. He's starting to question God's existence, and God doesn't like that. And if you read the entire 38th chapter of the book of Job, God explains to Job, where were you when I laid the foundations of the world? I mean, where were you at when I was walking on the depths of the ocean? Job, don't you be questioning me. You need to understand that I've got your best interests at heart, but you're going to have faith and trust me. But in the midst of that, God even speaks a great mystery. It says here in verse 31, so you go to Job 38, 31. Canst thou bind the sweet influences of Pleiades or loose the bands of Orion? What is that? Are you serious? Loose the bands of Orion. That's like saying, take something in the constellation of Orion and release it. And that's been the discussion by scientists and folks that have been studying the constellation, astronomers, all for years, is that in the constellation of Orion, there is a planet or huge star or something that is moving in a binary system. It's not going to hit us. But as it goes by, and it's bringing planets around it, stars, tons of asteroids, and as it goes by, its asteroids are going to smash into or collide into some of our asteroids in our galaxy, which could create this pinball effect, if you will, in the cosmos. And if you go to David Wilkerson in 1973, he gave a prophecy for 52 minutes. He stood in front of 2,000 people, and he prophesied 41 things the Lord showed him were going to come to pass. And of those 41 things, 40 of them have come to pass. The only thing that hasn't was a cosmic storm that he saw in the heavens. All right? Just saying. That was 1973. Well, as this elusive Planet X, what I'm finding out from others that are studying this deeply, including those that are in the government intelligence, are saying this Planet X, if you will, is actually a huge star or sun type, almost like our sun, but way larger. And so to make our sun burn, it needs helium and hydrogen. That's what fuels the sun. It's pulling helium and hydrogen from the space around it. But this other thing is so big, it requires more what? Helium and hydrogen. And so as it goes by, at some point, it could be that it sucks the hydrogen and helium away from our sun and darkens it for 3 days. You say, Paul, that's ludicrous, that's insane, that's madness. Are you serious? It happened in the days of Moses. The plagues of Egypt, one of the plagues was the sun went dark for 3 days. And it also says this will happen. We know that the sun actually went backwards 10 degrees. Hezekiah saw it on the sundial and he freaked out. I was in Jerusalem in June, and I was walking. We were cutting through I was with Stephen Bendenoon, his wife, and my wife Heidi. We're cutting through a garden, and we come upon a huge sundial. And I looked at my watch, and it was 2 p.m. in the afternoon. I looked at the sundial, and the shadow said it was 2:30. I said, wait a minute. What's your watch saying? He says 2 p.m. I said, so is mine. I said, but the sundial says 2:30. He said, it's impossible. All the sundials are set according to the position of the sun. No matter where they're setting, no matter what time of year it is, it won't matter. The shadow will always hit the right time on your watch. I go, it's not. It's a half hour off, 10 degrees. That has already happened before. That happened in the days of Hezekiah as a sign from God. So here's the point. If scientists are correct, that this elusive planet X that's going by in the constellation of Orion, if it's been loosed by God, and as it goes by, could it actually darken our sun for 3 days? We shouldn't be shocked because it's happened before. Now you go with me back to Joel 2, which we just read. And Joel tells us, as we said in verse 31, here's what it says. Joel 2, 30 and 31, and I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord come. Is it possible that we're on the brink of seeing, oh, by the way, Joel 2, to read the rest of the chapter about the coming of the Lord. Everything in it is coming to pass. So why should the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, the great harvest of salvation is coming, the restoring of Israel as a nation, it's all happened. So why should we be shocked about the constellation of Orion, which is mentioned twice in your Bible, and why would God bring it up? Oh, and by the way, Jesus said these words. Go with me to Luke 21 for a moment. Jesus says these words in verse 10 and 11. When asked the question about all the signs of the end times, Jesus says this. Oh, you know, there's going to be wars and rumors of wars and all that. Nation rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. Verse 11. And great earthquakes shall be in diverse places, and famines and pestilences and fearful sights and great signs shall there be from heaven. What? I didn't make this up. Don't get mad at me. Jesus is telling you that there will be things that will be great. Joel calls it great wonders. Jesus calls it great signs and fearful sights, and that men will even fall dead for fear of what's coming upon the earth. Oh, I'll be right. Don't you dare move. I'll be right back in just a moment with the rest of this message on the great signs in the heavens. Secrets of the Sacred Incense, an unbelievable, extraordinary journey to find the apothecary, the mystical caves in the Holy Land where the sacred incense of the first temple were discovered. Come with me on a journey that will literally enlighten you to the truth of the last days, the biblical ramifications of the third temple, all in this powerful DVD. Get a copy of it now at my website. All right, grab your Bible. You know where we're going. Right back to these scriptures again. Signs in the heavens. Matter of fact, go with me to Luke 21. Let's read verse 11 again. It says, Jesus was asked the question, can you tell us the sign of thy coming and when these things are going to come to pass or the end of the world? And you know Jesus talks about false Christs, false prophets and wars and rumors of wars and earthquakes and all kinds of pestilence. But look what he says in verse 11. And great earthquakes shall be in divers places, and famines and pestilences and fearful sights and great signs shall there be from heaven. All right? That's just, I mean, just you don't just randomly throw that in there. And Jesus will come right back to this thought again. Look what he says. Go with me to verse 25. Luke 21, verse 25. And there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars. And upon the earth, distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. There will be signs in the sun, moon, stars. Joel confirmed that. Sun will become darkened, moon will turn to blood. Okay? Now, look at verse 26. These signs are not just going to be some like, huh, I wonder what that is. Hang on. Men are going to understand what they mean. And they're going to be so afraid. Maybe it's an incoming asteroid. Maybe it's something out there that's so beyond their control. And it's all done naturally because it's done by God. And God told us. Jesus is saying these things are going to be happening in the last days. All right, go with me. Luke 21, 26. Men's hearts failing them for fear and for looking after those things which are coming on the earth. For the powers of heaven shall be shaken. What? And so, in other words, Jesus is saying, the heavens, he's going to shake the heavens. Well, what could shake the heavens? What in the world could do that? And you say, well, God did it. Right, and God always uses natural events. Parts the Red Sea, strong east wind came and blew all night, tells you in the Bible. Great earthquakes, all kinds of different things that have happened, scientifically can be proven. And but here's the thing about it. When these signs are happening, the events on the earth are going in concert with it. In other words, whatever's going on in the spiritual world manifests as in the physical. I've done a show here before called The Seven Prophetic Earthquakes. Blow your mind. Some of the biggest prophetic events of the Bible were at the same time were matched with earthquakes. So, you know, including the crucifixion of Christ and the resurrection of Christ, including the law being delivered to Moses on Mount Sinai and the mountain shaking. I mean, we can go on forever, and there's even more than seven. So what I'm saying is, Jesus is saying, when the whole world's a mess in Luke 21 or Matthew 24, also the heavens are going to be shaking, and people are going to see it and fall dead out of fear. Now, you don't have to have any fear if you've got Jesus, because look what Jesus tells you in the next verse. Look at verse 27. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. The heavens are shaken. The earth is quaking. The devil's back is breaking. And the Lord is coming, okay? I mean, are you serious? I mean, I get excited every time I read these scriptures. And then look what it says in verse 28. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up. Don't go run and hide in a bunker somewhere. Look up. Lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. If you're not saved, people will be falling dead of heart attacks because it's out of their control and they don't know what's going to happen. If you are saved, look up. You're going to see Jesus Christ coming. All right? He's coming in the clouds with power and great glory. Now, Let's go to Revelation because, again, Jesus' words of prophecy in Matthew 24, Luke 21, Mark 13, they're all reiterated in Revelation. And, oh by the way, don't forget, Old Testament prophets like Joel and Zechariah and Daniel will confirm the words of Christ and the revelation given to John in the book of Revelation. All right, if you go to Revelation chapter 8, verse 8 through 11, let's read what the scripture says. Certainly there's going to be some deep impacts on the earth. There's no getting out of that. Matter of fact, we just had an asteroid hit just off the coast of Australia here recently. And when it hit, it shook I mean, it lit the sky up. Hundreds of people called into their police stations. It shook the ground. They thought it was an earthquake, except people saw the sky light up, and then it knocked even power out. Several villages and towns lost power. It was an asteroid, a very small, very small. And it was not, we didn't get a warning from NASA. You know, NASA, you can go there, they got what's called near Earth objects, and they'll give you a list of all the asteroids. They got names, how big they are, when they're gonna go whizzing by the Earth, how close. But the one that exploded over Russia was not listed by NASA. The one that hit just off the coast of Australia was not listed by NASA. And NASA says, we just didn't see it. Okay. Either they didn't see it, or if the ones that are going to hit us, they're just not going to tell us. Because let me just say something. If you're NASA, and you know right now that in 6 months and 14 days, we're going to get hit with a rock the size of a football field, are you going to tell us that and give us a 6 months head start? Do you know what kind of panic would hit this Earth? It would be insanity. You just can't tell people, all right? But then you wonder, why are the elitists building underground cities in every major nation of the world that can hold as many as 10,000 people with hospitals and food storage and water and ventilation systems in case of the coming apocalypse? Just saying, just saying. Okay, look, let's see what Jesus said in Revelation 8, verse 8. And the second angel sounded, as it were a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea, and a third part of the sea became blood. And the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died. And a third part of the ships were destroyed. And the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven, burning as it were a lamp. And it fell upon the third part of the rivers and upon the fountains of waters. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. Same thing that it says in Amos 5. And the third part of the waters became wormwood. And many men died of the waters because they were made bitter or poisonous. So wormwood in Revelation is also mentioned by the prophet Amos in the 5th chapter. And he puts it with the constellation of Orion. And the planet, gigantic, whatever it is, burning sun planet, it's got 7 stars or 7 planets running around it, is in the constellation of Orion. Is it a binary system? Will it go by the Earth? And as it goes by, will its asteroids crash into these asteroids? Are you serious? I don't know. I just know we're going to have 2 deep impacts. I just know Jesus said men are going to die of heart attacks from what they see coming. I just know that the water is going to turn blood red, and the sun's going to turn dark, and the world is going to mourn, and great sorrow is going to come up on the Earth, and some people are not going to be ready, and others are going to be ready. And if you want me to go to Revelation 6, I could, and show you where the kings of the earth and the mighty men and the rich men and the chief captains will hide themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains and their underground cities, and they will cry to the mountains, fall on us and hide us from the face of him that sits on the throne. I mean, are you serious? The Bible is true, and the current events that are happening before your very eyes were prophesied to happen in your Bible. And so, on a daily basis, we do a live broadcast from 12 noon to 2 p.m. Eastern every day at my website at www.paulbegleyprophecy.com. We will go live every day. We share with you the current world events and how they relate to biblical prophecy. And you can even get in the chat room and communicate with us. I want you to know that you're living in the last days. Do I know when Jesus is coming? No. Do I know when the asteroids are going to hit the Earth? No. Do I know when the water's going to turn poisonous? No. But do I know what's going to happen? Yes. And so should you. Are you saved? Give your life to Jesus Christ. We're running out of time. I'll be right back in just a moment. Folks, let me tell you something. I have a book I really recommend you should get. You go to my website at www.paulbegleyprophecy.com. I have a book entitled The Zombie Apocalypse. Now, it has to do with 35 actual accounts of demonic possession and manifestations that is very troubling, but will help you understand how demon spirits actually work in these last days. I highly recommend you get it also for your teens and college students to help explain to them the pitfalls to not fall into these sorcery or witchcraft seances, Ouija boards, or some video games that could alter the mind and the soul of your child. Again, this book, it's only at my website at www.paulbegleyprophecy.com. There you'll find it on the products page. It'll be a blessing to you, insightful, and you'll bless the ministry. All right. This is fascinating stuff. I mean, you have to admit, it really is. And when you take a look at the Bible and realize that the designer of the entire universe loves you, just stop for a minute. He put the stars in the sky, put us spinning around our sun perfectly, created an atmosphere that we can live in here on this beautiful blue planet. No matter where you may go into outer space, there's nothing as gorgeous and beautiful than the earth itself. Created man from the dust of the ground, breathing his nostrils the breath of life. Man became a living soul, made us in the image and likeness of God. It's incredible to think that the designer, the grand designer, the intelligent designer of all things loves you. Loves you so much that even when you and I were in our fallen condition, he gave his son to set us free. Are you saved? I don't know about you, but I'm not going to sit around and wait to see until a big rock hits me in the head. I don't need it. I need to get right. I need to have the joy of Christ. And so whenever I hear of these things happening in the heavens, I start looking around to see if I can see Christ coming, because the Bible told me to look up, lift up my head. My redemption's drawing nigh, or getting close. Are you saved? You know, if you'll give your life to Jesus Christ, I'd love for you to come to Christ. I really would. Matter of fact, you can contact us. You can write us. Tell us that you are saved, that you've prayed. Maybe come to our website and get right in the chat room. And just say, look, I'm here from the television broadcast. I'm wanting to get saved. Or show up at the 12 noon to 2 p.m. We're also not only live at our website, we're live on YouTube. We go live simultaneously on YouTube. We're simultaneously live on YouTube, on new live stream, Roku, satellite, wherever. And as you're watching these television broadcasts, know this, that God has appointed you for such a time as this. You can be saved right now. And if you'll ask Jesus into your heart, call upon the name of the Lord, you shall be saved. Do you want to be? I just ask Jesus in. Father, in the name of Jesus, help these that are calling upon your name. Forgive them, Lord, of their sins. Cleanse them from all unrighteousness. Come into their spirit. Set them free. And whom you said the Son of Man makes free is free indeed. Thank you, Lord, for your marvelous grace, for your mercy. It endureth forever. And we'll give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. I hope that you have just done that, and that if not, that you will, because we truly are living in the last days. This is the coming apocalypse.